ready to worship tonight, church? Let's give God a shout of praise tonight.
Over, and time alive.
Lord. And it's because of you, Lord, that we have the joy to rejoice in you, God. We bless you. We honor you, Lord. We exalt your holy name. Because you are worthy. You're the reason why we sing. You're the reason why we rejoice. You're the reason why we dance. It's all because of you, Jesus. We bless you.
God good tonight? Amen. So let the King of my heart be the mountain where I run. And I drink from, oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life, oh, he is my song. Sing it out.
Let the King of my heart.
by chance, there's a reason you're here. You have called us by name. You knew us by name before we knew who we were. You knew us in our mother's womb. You called us with a purpose, God. We call out that purpose. You gave us purpose. You gave us life.
Sing it to his heart.
There will be no one like you, no one beside you. You alone are worthy of all praise.
As we go into this next song, I just want you to realize that in this moment, it's just you and Jesus. In this moment, nothing else matters. It's you and it's the King that's here. So sing this song. I kept on hearing God in my heart say, sing it to my heart. Sing it to my heart. Each one of you, sing it to the Lord's heart right now.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you.
It's the reason why we're here.
Jesus, the name above every other name. And Jesus, the only one that could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like. There is none beside you.
how to love you like you loved us, God. Sing worthy of every song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh. Lord, in this moment, I just pray, Father, that you wreck every single person here with your love, God. Father, show us how to love like you love us, Lord, so we can build our lives on that foundation, God. Father, I pray that you meet us right here where we're at, Lord. That your love would come at us, Lord. Just take a moment to receive that, church. Just take a moment. Close your eyes and take a moment to receive that love right now. Because the Lord is here and the Lord's imparting it right now. If you don't know, if you're saying to yourself, man, I don't know how I'm going to love my enemies, just say, Lord, show me how you loved me. And show me how to radiate that love in this moment. Just let the Lord just speak to you right now. In this moment, in this quiet moment. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We receive it, Father. We receive it, Lord. We receive your love here tonight. A love without condemnation, Lord, in this place.
To you. I want to embrace you, for now you've become my power. You're as real to me as a bedrock beneath my feet, like a castle on a cliff, forever my fortress, my mountain of hiding and my pathway of escape, my tower of rescue where no one can reach me, my secret strength and my shield around me. You are the salvation's ray of brightness shining on the hillside, always the champion of my cause. All I need to do is to call you, sing to you, my praiseworthy God, and when I do, I am safe and sound in you. For when the death ropes surround and wrap around me and terrified torrents of destructions overwhelm me, taking me to death's door, to doomed domain, I cried out to you, my distress, the delivering God. And from your temple throne, you heard my troubled cry, and my sobs came right into your heart, and you turned your face to rescue me. This verse, I felt like the ropes that are tied around the necks of this youth generation is gonna burn and disintegrate in front of your feet. And we prayed this morning that suicide, depression, anxiety would fall in the name of Jesus and they would bow to his feet. And I believe that there are new people here tonight who need to hear that God's not done and God's not annoyed whenever you fall into depression over and over again. And cycles is not your calling. It's not your calling to be in a cycle for your whole life. Your calling is not to be a student. Your calling is not to be an average. Your calling is not to live mediocre. It's not to live in a season of depression and to accept everything around. And when I read that, I knew that whenever you need to remember that I need something bigger, this is not enough, this will not do. Just remember that the secret place and the hiding place is Jesus. And if you have to do something risk, like if you have to get up here and do something, you know what I mean? Like do something you've never done before, I encourage you to go for it. And I encourage you to just remember that the noose around your neck does not belong there. That Jesus will take it off only with a question. If you say, Jesus, take it off for me, tonight's the last night you're gonna have to deal with that anxiety. Tonight's the last night you're gonna have to deal with fear of your future. Tonight's the last night you're gonna have to deal with suicidal thinking. Tonight's the last night you're gonna have to think, why do I compare myself every day? Why am I not enough? Why is my identity always on the attack? And I'm here to tell you, and I'm here to just be a witness and let you know, I'm a survivor of being depressed. I'm a survivor of that, and God saved me from that. And He's here to do that for you.
Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall, but You have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for You have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands, great is Your faithfulness, Your faithfulness. promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness.
Promise still.
Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet.
God is faithful. God is good. Scripture teaches us that as Jesus was heading back to the Father after he had been victorious in resurrecting 3 days in the tomb, after being in the tomb for 3 days, he turned around and he told his disciples, "I leave you. But now you will go out and you will do greater things. You will do bigger things." And I believe that word is for us as well, this generation. I believe he can do it again. I believe he could do it in every person here, and he could do it bigger and better. Turn around and tell three people really quickly, he's gonna do it again. Now tell those three people, he's gonna do it bigger and better. He's gonna do it bigger and better. But as we were singing this, and if you were, you know a little bit about us and the region, we love this song. We've been singing it now for about a year and a half. And we realized something, that God wants to do it again, but you have to believe it. You can't just sing it to sing it and fill a space. You gotta actually believe it in your heart and say, he will do it again. I believe that the time of miracles isn't over yet.
Oh yeah.
It's not over. It's not done. I believe the time of Pentecost is not over. If anything, Pentecost is, it says that as we get closer to the coming of Jesus, some will get cold, but the cold, the church, should seek him harder. And should seek to be closer. So I think it's not over. So as we sing one more time tonight, it's okay. I understand. I've understood that it's not for everyone. It's only those that are really, really, really willing to believe. So I ask you tonight, do you believe he can do it again? I believe it. So we're gonna do something. Maybe you need to give yourself some space really quick. Maybe you need to tell the person you're with, hey, you know what? I'm about to go in deep right now. I'm sorry, I need some elbow room. I need a little space really quickly. And I love to see young people that don't give up. Let's just worship, open up your heart, and just say it with all your heart. We read about it, we know it, but we believe you can do it again, and it starts tonight. We believe your promises still stand, and we will see you do it again. We will see you do it again. Those same three people you told them, do it again. Turn around, give them a high five. Tell them, get ready, get ready, get ready. He's gonna do it again. He's gonna do it again. You could head back to your seats, or if you feel comfortable, you could take a seat right there where you're at. There is no better place to be than in His presence.